previous friends speakers, I believe, stuck to their time limit, so I've saved some time. Maybe I can use their time now, because I'm a bit bad at being conscious of time, though I believe that there is a way for reminding us of that. Friends, I'll speak about my own experience in this journey. I won't speak much about my own organization or its domain details, because for that one can, we have our literature, we have our website, etc. District people can visit that, but I'll share some insights and learnings which I had, which I think can be of use to everyone, meaning their own ways. So I share this, this journey starting from a background. I did engineering from IIT Kharagpur. Then for 1 year I was at Infosys in Bangalore. Then I joined IIM Calcutta in 2001, completed MBA. But while at IIM, I did not appear for the placement process. I was the only student at IIM for 35-40 years of IIM Calcutta's history before that, who did not apply for placements, though completing the course, 2 year program. Now, basically, many people asked me about why I did this, etc. One thing was that I was really fascinated with the idea of leadership based on moral authority. I was fascinated by many people, our entire, legacy of the freedom movement, etc. But even in post-student, there are people like, say, Vinoba, for example, who just by an appeal to the landed class, led the world's largest land grip movement, Bhutan, in which millions of, crores of acres of land were donated by people. Just a non-violent, complete non-violent manner, an appeal of love, basically, love and sharing. For example of J.P. Jayaprakash Narayan, who led to the armed surrender of the most feared dacoits in the Chambal Valley, which the state with all its power and apparatus had failed to bring about. So, these kind of examples, and during that time this entire theory behind, you could say, this special power between such individuals. I always wonder what's the special power behind these individuals, because everywhere in, say, corporate sector, for example, or in bureaucracy, in politics, everywhere we see that power generally comes from a prestige of position. So you have some kind of position designation in your organization, because that you feel an authority, you've been given legitimate authority for that, and through that you exercise power. But such individuals, I wonder where their source of power lay.